Gatecrash is the second set in the already successful Return to Ravnica block. And what's more, it's the first ever large set release in February. The second set of a block has never been this big. Players will be doubly excited to pick up and play with the set. So be sure to be prepared with enough stock on hand and plan for a great series of in-store events. As we've seen from the unprecedented success of the Return to Ravnica events, this war between the guilds makes for some exciting in-store gameplay, as your players fight for the dominance of their guild, along with their own personal victory. Continuing the Return to Ravnica block's theme of the struggle between the city's many powerful guilds, Gatecrash challenges players to choose and fight for one of the city's other five guilds. This time, players will be able to align themselves with the Boros Legion, the Gruul Clans, House Dimir, the Orzhov Syndicate, or the Simic Combine. Look forward to a store full of great gameplay and excited players. It's a powerful combination that will just keep going, strengthening and building your community of players all year round. And this video will help you to make the most of your Gatecrash events. It all gets started at the pre-release. There's always a lot of excitement and anticipation leading up to pre-release events, because they're the first chance players get to play with a new set. Of course, it's always a good idea to get your players to pre-register for your events, so you can be prepared too. And if you have concerns about having enough space, consider allowing players to only pre-reg for a single event, then let them sign up for additional events on the day of your pre-release. And pre-releases attract all types of players, new and old, so be sure to do everything you can to make the event special. On our end, we'll be sending you a number of materials, starting with a pre-release kit. The most important pieces in the kit are the poster and the countertop standee. You'll want to be sure to put these on display as soon as you get the kit to help let your customers know the pre-release is coming, so they can make plans to attend. Just as with the Return to Ravnica pre-release, a big part of the fun for players will be choosing the guild they'll be fighting for. So you'll want to have the guild information cards close at hand or on display to provide a quick overview of each of the set's guilds, along with their color combinations. Knowing what guilds people will be playing will help you make the most of the guild pre-release packs you'll be receiving. You'll get five different guild pre-release packs, one for each of the five guilds in Gatecrash. Inside each guild pre-release pack, players will find a variety of things, including five Gatecrash booster packs, a guild booster pack containing 15 guild-aligned cards, and a guild promo card unique to that guild that's playable at the pre-release. Players will also find an achievement card, which challenges them to do various things during gameplay that just add some fun, guild-specific flavor to the event. Of course, as the organizer, you can always come up with rewards for players that manage to check off all the achievements on their card. Whatever you do, keep in mind the more you do to make your pre-release event entertaining and fun for your players, the more likely they'll come back. Launch weekend is always exciting. Not only is it the first chance players will have to buy Gatecrash product, but it also kicks off a whole new season of in-store gameplay. During the weekend Gatecrash launches, we encourage you to offer the events that best serve your customers, whether that's standard, booster draft, sealed deck, or something else entirely. Of course, a great way to start the festivities is with Friday Night Magic. FNM is one of the most effective in-store play programs you can run for building a strong, vibrant player community. And to support your efforts during the launch weekend, we'll include 50 additional foil promo cards for each FNM you sanction, up to two events. These promo cards can be used in any event you run during launch weekend. Distribute them to your players as you see fit throughout the weekend, and be creative. Make the launch weekend exciting for your customers so they'll return next time. Also kicking off during launch weekend is the Gatecrash League. Players are attracted to the league because of its flexibility. They can play matches at just about any time. Though you'll find that setting up a designated league playtime will also help players meet up. Inside the Gatecrash League marketing kit are a number of things that will help you build awareness and excitement for the league. First, you'll find a set of five banners, each featuring the colors and symbol of one of the five guilds in the Gatecrash set. You'll also get 25 deck boxes, that's five for each of the guilds. Whether you use them as incentives to participate in the league, as awards, or just as giveaways while they last, how you distribute them is up to you. The last thing you'll find inside the Gatecrash League marketing kit is a wall clock with interchangeable faces. You can display whichever face you want, but you might consider using it to show players which guild is currently leading in your store. So that's what you'll find in the marketing kit. Now, let's take a look at the league kit. The double-sided tracking poster will help to keep track of your players, the guilds they're fighting for, and their progress. The poster is the same on both sides because it, and all the materials in the kit, should support two leagues of up to 16 players. That's why you'll find 32 progress cards, each with its own lanyard. Give one of these to each player when he or she signs up. These will make it easier for players to identify each other when playing at your store. You'll notice the progress cards have spots on them, representing each of the guilds. That's what the sheets of guild symbol stickers are for. When a player completes all of his or her matches for the week, you should give them a sticker to place on their achievement card. Players will be interested in the alternate art token cards. These are to be awarded to the top 10 finishers in each of your two leagues. So when you're finishing your first league, be sure to set aside half of them so players have something to shoot for in round two. Of course, adding in other prizes on your own will make the league more exciting and rewarding for your players. Game Day is the first global standard event supporting Gatecrash. Your players will be excited to finally play the standard deck they've been working on after experiencing the pre-release, launch weekend, and even the Pro Tour. Help build their excitement by highlighting the fact that Game Day is a fun, spirited competition with great prizes. The Game Day kit provides you with 30 full art promo cards to give away, one for each person who plays in the event. The top 8 finishers will also get one of these foil promo cards, and the first place winner also walks away with bragging rights and the champion playmat to prove it. All of your in-store play events are what you make of them, so make them big. Make them fun, exciting, and memorable. The more you put into your events, the more your players will get out of them. And that's what'll entice them to keep coming back and to bring their friends along. And that's how you build a strong and vibrant player community. Gatecrash is going to be big. And when you really push your events to the next level, Gatecrash could be huge. And for more information about Friday Night Magic or the Return to Ravnica pre-release, including the pre-release guild packs, see the videos listed here. Thanks for watching.